Making a life worth living and retirement worth having is really about making some things so impressive to others that allows them to believe that we have the magic of the Lord in us. Some people don't want to believe that God does provide people with gifts, literally gifts that come from heaven. Sometimes they see this in the people in their lives, other times they recognize this in the positions that they get into from their careers or their professional outlooks, but other times it's literally something as simple as finding something on sale that really was a surprise and sort of a different way of going about doing your life. In my practical understanding of the Lord, I have learned that the more that I submit, the more that I gain in terms of not only my own spiritual lessons, but in terms of how other people relate with me. When I really listen to God saying, pause, don't speak yet, and that sort of thing in my heart, mind, and soul, I'm able to produce a better relationship with someone. You see, it's really about listening to what is right for that individual that makes us all the difference in the world in terms of getting our relationships back on track or moving them further along the track of life that they're supposed to be on. Many people make mistakes in the way that they look at life. They sometimes think, I'll just utilize this person for a short time, then I'll throw them out and pick up another person, and I'll just continue on my little plan. That's not precisely how the Lord plans things. He actually plans life partners, if you will, for people. Life partners can be different types of partners. They can be lovers and intimate nature, but also they can be simply profitable partnerships, people who are supposed to help you to move your life forward. When someone refuses to teach you part of their skill sets, it's sort of like them saying, you know, I don't feel like playing God's game today. I'm just going to do what I like in my life, and I'm not going to help you one second because it's not on my plan for my day. As opposed to looking at it as maybe this request for help is coming about because it's supposed to not only help the individual who's seeking help, but is actually going to help the person who's got to give the help in terms of their performance, in terms of their abilities to learn to teach better, or in terms of their proper ways of training people to do more in life, to be more productive, to have higher performance, because team performance often impacts those who are in multi-level marketing as well as in corporations. You see, there's not a lot of difference between the two. There's usually people at the top who earn more than people at the bottom. That's the way that most corporations work. Even though I've talked many times about how important it is and how impressive it is that there's a lot of companies out there going to a lateral style, which literally means that everyone from the CEO down to the janitor makes the same salary, and then when the company succeeds, they all get the same level raise. That way there's no improper jealousies, there's nobody in poverty, and there's nobody literally not doing what they should for that company. Now think what a wonderful world that would be in if we all lived in that peaceful, harmonious sort of way. I guess what I'm really talking about is how do we make a life worth living and retirement worth having if there are literally people out there trying to improve and impede our little right to get that life that the Lord has planned for us. You see, when they start monkeying around in our lives, it changes and shifts the plan that Lord God had for us, whether it was to align us with a next life partner, or whether it was to align us with a strategic alliance who can help us make a profit, or whether it was to put us in a position to get a new career job, or something like that. We never know who that one person in our life that we meet as a stranger can become for us, or the lifetime and length of time that that relationship can flourish. You see, it's the Lord's love that puts these people on our path. Sometimes they teach us lessons, absolutely. Other times we gain things from them, like how to do stuff, how to improve stuff, how to strategize stuff. And literally we can gain from them intelligence of mind, wickedness of wit, and all sorts of other aspects of relational impressiveness, if you will, or a hunger for a resource can also be a part of that particular relationship. But in time, we have to literally look at how do we help someone move forward in life after loss? How do we make sure we're showing them enough care and kindness that they literally will move on and move forward and be better for our help as opposed to worse for the wear of having endured our help? You see, there's two types of people. There's people who want to help a person towards their personal goals that the Lord in heaven has placed on their heart to follow their dreams too. And then there's another type of person like a mom or a sibling who literally just thinks, I know what's best for this individual. I'm going to manage this person. I'm going to lie to them. I'm going to do everything I can to force them down this road. And what they'll discover is that it creates a lot more mayhem for the individual, as well as a legality, a liability for those who've been playing house and pretending to be willing to help people. Now, in life, we have moments of time to make all the difference is not true. We have moments of time to repair relationships, moments of time to show love, moments of time to honor peace, and moments of time to walk the path of Jesus in other people's lives. If you have that ability, then you understand what I'm talking about, and I'm singing to the choir. But if you haven't learned how to master your relationships, then maybe, just maybe, you need to start talking more to people like me, who may not be the most socially well-endowed in terms of having a litany of friends in an intermediate circle, but of the people that I have had in my life, the relationships moved into intimacy levels very quickly because of the level of listening skills I have, because of the practical advice and knowledge that I can give to them based on some of the gifts of the Spirit that the Lord has provided me, and I'm not ashamed to say it. But in truth, you'll find this at the end of the audio file so that I can't be jerked around for my religious freedom. And that's what we're looking at. We're looking at people who need to understand the law so that they know what to do in life and where they can go and how far they can literally take something before it becomes a hate crime, hazing, harassment, and other aspects of life. Now, this has been Blake Ensign of Blaze Communications, LLC, saying appropriately so. Thanks for listening.